During this hour of Eucharistic adoration, it's an hour of prayer. It's an hour to reside and to remain with Christ in a very special way. And I'd like to begin just with a gospel reading and just a few words to guide prayer. This is from John chapter 3, Nicodemus and Jesus. Now there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night and said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher, come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do unless God is with him." Jesus answered him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born anew, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Nicodemus said to him, "How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. That which is born of the flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Do not marvel that I say to you, you must be born anew. The wind blows where it wills, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit." Nicodemus said to him, "How can this be?" Jesus answered, "Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand this? Truly, truly, I say to you, we speak of what we know and bear witness to what we have seen, but you do not receive our testimony. The Son of Man must be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life." This is from the Gospel of John, chapter 3, the story of Nicodemus, and it points to water and of the Spirit, and living in water and of the Spirit. And what we say as Catholics is that this is baptism. This is the life that we're living in. We're living in the life of baptism, the life of baptized individuals, which brings us into the church, which incorporates us into the body of Christ. Now, during this time, I'd like to just extend this gospel to you because those who are in baptism have the presence of Christ and the Spirit of God with them in a very particular way, in a unique way, in a very special way. And we can trust that. We can have confidence that God is with us, that God is working, that God is hearing our prayers, especially because we are born of water and of the Spirit. So we can have this trust, we can have this confidence, we can know for a fact that the God of all things, that Jesus Christ, that the Holy Spirit is with us and working in our lives and hearing our prayers. And so I wanted to extend this prayer session, this holy hour, to all of you to pray however it is that you normally pray, but to have this trust and to have this confidence during this time when we're in our homes, when we're trying to pray in a special way to God, since we can't gather together as we normally would, but to have this trust and to have this confidence that Christ is with us, that God is with us, and that his graces are abundant. So I offer this holy hour for all of you, and we will be praying for all of you during this time, and we ask that you pray for our church and for all of us. Let us pray. Lord our God, you have given us the true bread from heaven. In the strength of this food, may we live always by your life and rise in glory on the last day. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Divine praises. Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception.
Blessed be her glorious Assumption.
Blessed be her glorious Assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be St. Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.